Hi everyone, this is Manvi Singh. I am a student of IIM Law College and I am a legal intern in Lexis and Company. So the topic is the Citizenship Amendment Act. India is a secular, sovereign and peaceful loving country. Perhaps it is the only and country in the world that has justified the slogan of unity in diversity. Perhaps the citizens of many countries wants Indian citizenship. The Citizenship Amendment Bill 2019 has been passed by the Lok Sabha on 9 December 2019. This bill is signed by the President on 12 December 2019. That is why it has become as act now. So now the question is raised here, which is what is Citizenship Amendment Act, which is called CAA, and 2019. So the answer is the Citizenship Amendment Act seeks to provide Indian citizenship to illegal refugees from six communities. These six communities includes Hindu, Buddhist, Sikh, Christians, Jain, Parsis. Vote to the mentions that illegal migrants can be imprisoned or deported under the Foreign Act 1946 and the Passport Entries Act into 1920. Thus, two act empower the central government to check the entry, exits and residence of foreigners within Indian. So now another question is raised, what is the cutoff data for Indian citizenship? The cutoff data for Indian citizenship is December 31st for 2014, which means the applicant should have entered into India or on to those were forced to compel to take shelter in India due to persecution on the ground of their religion in their native country. Now the another question is raised, what do the Citizenship Amendment Act 1955 says? The Citizenship Amendment Bill 1955 describe the five countries of obtaining citizenship of India, such as citizenship by birth, citizenship by descent, citizenship by registration, citizenship by naturalization, and citizenship by the incorporation of territory. So these are the five citizenship of the Indians. So Citizenship Act of 1955, provisions and amendment. The Citizenship Act, the Citizenship Amendment Bill 1955 made it mandatory for a person to stay in India for at least 11 years to acquire citizenship naturally, which has later reduced to 6 years. But in the Citizenship Amendment Act 2019, this period reduces to 5 years. Now some are key features of Citizenship Amendment Act 2019. Under the Citizenship Act 1955, a person may be given an OCI card if he is of Indian origin. Example, a former citizen of India of their descent and or the spouses of a person of Indian origin. Now the act of 2019 give the facility to OCI cards card holder to travel in India, work and study in the country. Now the another key feature is the Citizenship Amendment Bill 2016 says that the citizenship of OCI holders that can be cancelled on the five grounds. First one is showing disaffection to the Constitution of India. Second one is registration through fraud. Third one is engaging with the enemy during war. Third one is damaging the sovereignty of India. And fifth one is sentences to the imprisonment for 2 years or more within the 5 years of the registration as OCI. Now the historical connection. The act does not give a carte blanche to the Hindus and Christians and Sikhs from other countries to come to India and get a citizenship. So because each of these has been civilization with India, with the circum The circumstances in which were partitioned from India have created the situation where Hindus and other minorities population. Now the conclusion of this topic is the Parliament has unfettered power to the make for the law. The country which has come through the citizenship, but the positions and the other political parties alleged to this act by the government violate some of the basic features of the constitution like secularism, equality. It may react the door of the Supreme Court, where the Supreme Court will be the final interprets. So if it is violate the constitution feature and goes ultra violence, wires, it will be struck down. If it is it is not, we will continue to have the law. So guys, this was all about this topic. Thank you so much for listening to me. Like, comment and share.